الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. All praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator and the sustainer of the universe. We send peace and blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with greatness in this world, bless us with the best of this world and the best of the next, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to live a life of peace and happiness, and that Allah show us even greater peace and even greater happiness in the company of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hereafter. Allahumma ameen. Welcome, my brothers and sisters, and this beautiful and blessed day of Friday, the day of Jum'ah, a day in which normally we congregate as a community. But today we are praying in our homes and trying to stay safe and trying to maintain and keep that life which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with as an amana, as a trust. And in keeping with the spirit of the day of Friday and looking to reflect upon the Quran and connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this afternoon I wanted to talk about a couple of ayat from Surat Yunus, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divides humanity into two groups. And here is Surat Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beginning with ayah number 7, where Allah describes two groups of people, basically those who will go to paradise and those who will go to fire, those who will be rewarded for their deeds and actions in this world, and how those people acted, and specifically what those people's words were, so that we can emulate them. And Allah gives us the stark contrast with the opposite, with those who are doomed in this world and doomed in the next. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah talks about إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَاطْمَأَنُّوا بِهَا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا غَافِلُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah talks about the group of people, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا. They ignore, or they forget, or they disregard the fact that they're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again one day. Meaning, and speaking to the concept of accountability, that each and every one of us is to be held accountable before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're going to be made to answer for our deeds, be made to answer for what we did in this world. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا. Those individuals who are not looking forward to meeting us, or they have completely disregarded the concept of meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, and those individuals who are totally comfortable with this life, meaning that they have no hope or no expectation that there is a world after this, that there is an existence after this, that these 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, however many years one may live on this world, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a peaceful life, but however many years or days or even moments are written for us in this world, these individuals who have disregarded the meeting of Allah think that this is it. This is all their eggs are in this basket right here. This is where all of their investments are. وَطْمَأَنُّ بِهَا. And those individuals who are comfortable with this life, meaning they think that this world is everything, so this is where I'm going to settle down. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا غَافِلُونَ. These individuals have been so negligent of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is telling us on a daily basis. In fact, from the moment you came into this world, Allah has been reminding you that you're going to leave this world. From the moment that any one of us was brought to life, we have to remember that at any moment, this life can be taken away from us. And this is how the believer lives, with one foot in this door and one foot in the door of the Akhirah. But those individuals who have disregarded the verses of Allah, the signs of Allah, those individuals who are not looking forward to meeting Allah and have neglected the concept of accountability, those individuals who are comfortable and content with just this life, أُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارِ. Those individuals will eventually find the hellfire. أُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. However, and there we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from being from this first group and make us from this next group. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. But those individuals who believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they make deeds, they believe and they act upon that belief. So it's not just enough to talk the talk, but you have to walk the walk as well. It's not just enough to believe in Allah, but you have to do something about that belief. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they do something about it, they do those good deeds. يَهْدِيهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِإِيمَانِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward them for the sake of their belief. تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. Allahu Akbar. That these individuals are going to be rewarded with an never-ending and ever-existing and luscious, ever-amazingness of paradise with rivers which flow underneath them. دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا. So now, how do the people of paradise speak? And Allah gives us this example so that we can emulate it in this world. That you think about a role model that you might take. If you wanted to go into a specific field of study, well, you're going to shadow somebody who's already studied or achieved that. You want to shoot a free throw, well, you're going to watch a certain player that's really good at free throws. You want to play the post, you want to run, you want whatever things that we do. This is how human beings live. We emulate people who came before us. We follow in people's footsteps. We watch and see those who have succeeded. But the problem with following in the footsteps of only those who we know of on this earth is that human beings are at a point going to fail. Human beings at some point are fallible. However, Allah is telling us about the people of paradise who have already signed, sealed, and delivered and stamped, had their entrance into paradise written for them. Allah talks about these individuals so that we can emulate the winners. We can emulate those who will not falter or fail. What happens? How do they speak? دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا. These people speak with the remembrance, the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا. While they're in paradise, this is how they speak. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمْ. Subhanallah. وَتَحِيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا سَلَامٌ. Saying, As-salamu alaykum. Peace be unto you. Taking the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَاهُمْ. And alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And the final words, the way that they end their conversations, the way that they end their thoughts, is with all praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what lesson should we take from this? Is that while we are here on this earth, that we emulate the people of paradise, that we say the words that the people of paradise say, with subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu akbar, assalamu alaykum, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.